Hello guys, and welcome to our first MetaQuest 3 tutorial video. I have the MetaQuest 3 already on me, as you can see. We are currently in virtual reality mode, and you can see I have two controllers with me, so you can see it actually mimics what I'm doing. Today we're gonna be using only two buttons. Or one button and one joystick. So this is the button that basically allows us to press and navigate the MetaQuest system, and the joystick will change the view and will help us to navigate if we have to scroll down. So let's start. We are in virtual reality mode, and if you turn on the headset, this is the first thing that you're gonna see is this menu taskbar. I will go through each function so you can understand what you can expect and how to navigate the MetaQuest. So let's start with the profile. So we navigate with our hand, and then we click with our finger, and then the menu will open. So here you see an overview of the account. Currently it's VRent 4. We do not have any followers or do not follow anyone. Here you can edit your profile, you can add your bio, or you can edit your avatar. This is the currently avatar I'm using. You can see there in the mirror. So yeah, this is very briefly about our account. Here, if you have multiple accounts on your Meta headset, you can switch between accounts. Now we do only have this account installed, but you can have up to three accounts on your MetaQuest 3 headset. So let's about this one for the moment, move on. Here you have a quick setting toolbar. Basically you have an overview of the MetaQuest charge, the controller charge, the current date. Here you can go then to the larger setting menu. I'll show it to you later. Here you can navigate the volume button and the brightness. I do not think you see the change in brightness on the video, but I do see it clearly now. Like, I mean, yeah, you can then navigate and adjust to the brightness that fits you the best. Left hand side you have the Wi-Fi. If you press, you will have the Wi-Fi setting network open for you. You see we're currently connected to this network, but then it will open up different networks and you can choose which one to connect to. So we are currently in the virtual reality mode, but with the MetaQuest 3 you can also have the pass-through mode. Let me show you how it looks like. So if we press pass-through, you see the surrounding, what is around you, currently in the living room, and basically you can navigate your MetaQuest 3 by having a very good overlook what is happening around you. So let's go back into virtual reality mode. You see, changes pretty fast. Here we have the Bluetooth function. You can add your headset, your headphones, or your computer. You can connect it to the headset with help of Bluetooth, and you have to use it for different functionalities. Exactly as you might know. Then the fourth function in this table is the boundary function. I have, if you press on the boundary function, you can see that I have already a boundary created around me. That's a stationary boundary, that's where I'm sitting. If we confirm, basically detects if I, for example, would like to move outside of the boundary, the circle will appear for the safety reasons, and if I completely move out of it, it will throw me back into the pass-through mode for the safety reasons. Exactly, so this is how the boundary works. You can create your own boundaries. So if you play a game that creates a bit more space, that needs a bit more space, you can very easily create your own and play without any disturbance. Like, for example, you will not see all the time the boundary appearing. Now, here you have the microphone function. If I press the microphone, you couldn't hear me. Here we have the view reset. For example, if you can move the menu bar, and if you have if you want to reset it, you could basically just press look up front and it will appear just in front of you. Exactly, so you can move this screen. This screen you can move as well, so you can do basically whatever you wish around. Then you also have the night display. You do not see it in the video, but now I have like blue light being dimmed, so it's better before you go to sleep to use the night display to have less blue light exposure. You also have do not disturb function, so it will silence notification. And here you have the shrink view button, which basically makes the views smaller. You see, if you press it again, you have a larger view of the screen. And here you can report a problem, and here you have a travel mode. It's basically like an airplane mode, which you can switch on for convenience, obviously. So not now. Exactly, so this is a quick setting. Close it. Here you also have notification bar. You have again switch distance. Switch it right here. Here you can again switch between pass-through mode and virtual reality mode. So you can see it changes quite fast. So it's very convenient. Going forward to the applications. So these ones that are here are general. They are basically here all the time. First you have the Horizon feed. Here you see all the applications, several news from the Meta, new games, some world events, and virtual world events, stadium, basically here's like UFC fights, videos, and apps for working in the VR, so different applications you see here. Going forward, we can go into the Meta Store. We have also different applications which you can purchase and install. You navigate with your joystick, move it up and down, left and right. Very easy to operate. You can also search for the apps if you already know the name, so it's very convenient. In this function, people, you can add friends. Search for people in virtual reality, play games together, add groups, contacts. Basically it's like your contact and friends platform. Then you can connect with other people and your friends. You also have a camera. I'm currently in the recording mode. You also can take a photo, go live and cast. Very simple. You see the recording button right here on the right, the red one. Then you also do have a browser. It is basically, you can here type any website. Let's type our webpage, vren.ch, and it will appear as you would see on your computer. You have the browser, you can, with the help of the joystick, you can scroll down, you can go up. Navigate. Basically it is very convenient as the Meta Quest 2. Exactly, so very simple, very convenient. You can close the bar, the tabs, you have the popular tabs and whatever is suggested for you here from the Meta. Then going forward, you also have files. You can see which ones are downloaded, media, recent. You can basically navigate through the files that you have in your Meta Quest and the photos that you have done. Then the next one is settings. This is a larger overview of the setting function. We will go deeper into the setting function in the next video, so stay tuned. For now, just for you to see the overlook of the settings menu. So this one is quick settings, the ones that you use more, and this one is the more detailed function. And now, last but not least, the library function, which I think is the most important. where you see all the apps and games installed on your MetaQuest 3 headset. You can navigate again with your joystick up and down. These are all the installed apps. You can filter them how you would like. And basically all this will include an uninstalled apps as well. But basically the more you use, the most used are the installed apps. So you can easily then, if you don't need one, for example, if I don't no longer need Roblox and I need the space on my MetaQuest, I can just simply uninstall it, free up the space, and if I would require it again, I can go here, not installed apps, press this button, always with this finger, just press install, you see, it's downloading. Now it will disappear from uninstalled apps. Go back. Yeah, back here, installed. Very simple, very easy to navigate. So yeah, this is the MetaQuest library. So as I said, this is a brief overview what you can do with the MetaQuest 3. These are the basic functions which you would need to know to navigate a bit around, to understand how the MetaQuest works. Joystick work exactly similar as your hands, so very easy and convenient. Hope this video was helpful. Stay tuned for more and wish you a very nice day. Thank you very much for watching. Bye bye.